It's political reality, that's but right. Political reality changes. And that's the important thing. I want to say one more thing about this, this whole problem that we've been talking about. And that is, going back to Bob Lampman's comment, there is one thing that can be said in favor of the welfare program, unaccustomed as I am to saying anything in favor of it, and that is that it is the only social program I know of which at least, on the average, gives money to people who are in lower income classes than those who pay the taxes. Every other welfare program, not only does a lot of money go to the people who are well off, but on the average, the poor are taxed and the well-to-do are subsidized. We in the upper income classes have been very clever at conning the poor suckers at the bottom to pay us nice salaries as bureaucrats and to provide us with nice benefits at their expense. And at least the welfare program doesn't do that.
And what you state with great confidence that it will come, the negative income tax, even though you recognize the hurdles. Why are you so sure it will come?
Because the present system has within it the seeds of its own destruction. There is no way in which a system constructed like the present, in my opinion, can avoid creating more and more social problems, and something is going to have to be done. Nobody has proposed any alternative. So far as I know, there is no effective alternative to the negative income tax. And so it gets knocked down, and it keeps rising, it gets knocked down, and it keeps rising.
Yeah, finally raise the question, though, whether in any modern industrial democracy like this one, it's conceivable the system could be run without a fairly elaborate welfare underpinning of some kind. What do you feel, Ms. Bowman?
I don't think it can be, because I think essentially the welfare, set of welfare programs reflect the values of this society, that if it didn't, there would have been revolt long before now. Yes, there are rumblings about its cost, and I think that's primarily a function of rapid rates of inflation eroding real income earning power of the middle class taxpayer. But I think on one level, we wanted to give up the responsibility of caring, the responsibility of day-to-day actual caring. And in a technical, modern, industrial society like we have, the tax system and the government system is probably is a viable alternative. I don't think we're going to get out of it. I don't think you're going to see private charities who can take my money that I am free to give or not give and essentially make a difference in people's lives of any substance on any level.
I don't think that has anything to do with society being modern, technological, or industrial. It has to do with an ideology, and particularly an ideology that is very strong among academic intellectuals and in the media. And I think that as time goes on and more intelligent ideas replace the kinds of vague visions that dominate today, that the political climate will change, and that's the only thing that stands in the way of reform right now.
James Dudson.
I don't think you're going to get rid of the system, but I'm interested in a welfare system. I'm interested in Tom's last statement about academicians and theorists and so forth. We forget that we're talking about people, and we may sit in the ivory tower and talk about whether this system will work and ideologically or ideologically why it won't work. At the same time, there are masses of people outside who are locked out of the system that you and I are part of. And somehow we've got to make sure that those people are taken care of. And the short of not doing it, of course, means that your safety and my safety and the vitality of this government and of our country is at stake. The mayor of the city of New York asked me when we had a strike, what would I do if I couldn't get checks out to people when our workers were on strike? And I said to him, after the first month, chaos. And he said, what do you mean? I said, no man or woman in the street of the city of New York, you included, Mr. Mayor, will be safe if we cannot take care of people.
Well, there we leave this discussion and hope you'll join us for the next episode of Free to Choose.
Next week, is equality every American's birthright? Is it healthy for a nation when the government tries to impose equality on all its citizens? How does that affect the freedoms of individuals? Don't miss Milton Friedman's Free to Choose next week.
Okay, so everything's gonna be fine. Just keep breathing in and out. Try not to breathe.